The Dijkstra algorithm converts routers, subnets, and links into a tree. Let's see it in action. This example, Layer 3 network, consists of LANs, containing hosts, connected via routers. The buildings represent LANs. You can imagine the equipment in the building that makes up the LAN. Each LAN is a separate IP subnet. To emphasize this, let's see the subnets separated from each other. The individual subnets can be regarded as jigsaw pieces that clip together to form the network. The points where the pieces clip together are the routers. The aim of the algorithm is to find the shortest path to each subnet, so we need to assign a length value to every link. In OSPF, the length of a link is actually referred to as a cost. The application of the Dijkstra algorithm to OSPF actually finds least cost paths. Link costs are related to link bandwidth. For this example, we've applied some arbitrary costs to the links, from the routers to the subnets. Turning the network into a tree. Every router can treat the network as a tree, with the router itself as the root. For example, let's build up the tree with R2 as the root. This means rearranging the subnets, jigsaw pieces, according to the Dijkstra rules. From the root, branches are added a subnet at a time, starting with the subnets directly connected to R2. The subnet with the least cost path is chosen at each step. Sticking to this rule results in a tree of least cost paths. If a subnet is already connected to the tree, but a less cost connection point becomes available, R1, move it to this less cost point. When R1 is connected to S1, this now creates a new connection point for S2 that has a cost of 32. This is less than the cost from R2 to S2 of 100, its current connection, so it moves. Also, note that the links from subnets to routers do not have costs associated with them. This is because the purpose of creating the tree is to find the least cost path from the root to any given destination. Once the tree is complete, the calculation of the least cost route to any given subnet in the network is simple. It is just a matter of working along the branches that lead from the root to that destination. The route R2 to S5 has a cost of 1 plus 10 plus 1 equals 12. The route R2 to S1 has a cost of 1 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10 equals 31.